Kamala knows how to govern. She knows how to make the hard calls.
That 1994 crime bill, it did contribute to mass incarceration in our country. It encouraged and was the first time that we had a federal three strikes law. It funded the building of more prisons in the states.
She's ready to do this job on day one. And we're both ready to get to work rebuilding this nation and building it better. As Attorney General of the largest state in the country, Kamala took on the big banks over mortgage fraud and won. Took on big oil and wanted to pollute without consequences.
There's no question I'm in favor of banning fracking. So, yeah, and starting with what we can do on day one around public lands. And then there has to be legislation. But yes, and this is something I've taken on in California. I have a history of working on this issue. And to your point, that we have to just acknowledge that the residual impact of fracking is enormous in terms of the impact on the health and safety of communities. Yeah, so thank you.
She was a pioneer in marriage equality and tackled the gun lobby. As a child of immigrants,
a lot of the signs at the rally you just held were people standing there saying, abolish ICE.
Yeah.
Is that a position that you agree with?
Listen, I think there's no question that we've got to critically re-examine ICE and its role and the way that it is being administered and the work it is doing. And we need to probably think about starting from scratch.
She knows personally how immigrant families enrich our country, as well as the challenges of what it means to grow up black and Indian American in the United States of America.
To coddle the reputations of segregationists, of people who, if they had their way, I would literally not be standing here as a member of the United States Senate, is, I think, it's misinformed and it's wrong.
Did you apologize for that?
He's going to have to make that decision. But, you know, let's be very clear that the senators that he is speaking of with such adoration are individuals who made and built their reputation on segregation. The Ku Klux Klan celebrated the election of one of them. So this is a very serious matter.
Her story is America's story. Different from mine in many particulars, but also not so different in the essential. She's worked hard. She's never backed down from a challenge. She has earned each and every of the accolades and achievements that she has gained, many of them. Often in the face of obstacles that others put in her way, never quit.
A campaign that started with so much promise brought to an abrupt end today, even before the first vote was cast.
I'm not a billionaire. I can't fund my own campaign.
Senator Kamala Harris, who sought to be the first black female president of the United States, calling the decision one of the hardest of her life.
I cannot tell you that I have a path forward. If I don't believe I do.
She shot to the top tier early, famously taking on Biden for his previous position on mandated busing to integrate schools.
There was a little girl in California who was part of the second class to integrate her public schools. And she was bused to school every day. And that little girl was me.
But Harris started to plateau in the polls, often struggling to defend her record as a prosecutor.
When you had the power, why didn't you try to affect change then?
So there have been, I'm glad you asked me this question. I made a decision that if I was going to have the ability to reform the system, I would try to do it from the inside. Was I able to get enough done? Absolutely not.
Over the weekend, signs the campaign was unraveling. New York Times obtaining a resignation letter from a Harris aide who said, I no longer have confidence in our campaign or its leadership.